We're here in Tubac. I'll make this a separate video, but here's the Tubac Presidio State Historic Park. And it does say that this is an Onza trailhead location right there. Kind of hard to see it behind the sign, but Onza trailhead. So we're going to go take a look at this. I've never gone in here before, but this is on the east end of town where all the stores are. Just, you know, keep going east and then you'll get to this place. And Presidio, for those that may or may not know, is Spanish for like a fort. So we're gonna go take a look. Stand by. Okay, we're up near the buildings now. Here's one of the buildings, and there's our flags, of course. We're gonna walk over here first, and there's a beautiful cactus garden back here. So let's take a look. We have a sign right here. Special thanks to our generous donors, volunteers, and the Green Valley Nursery for beautifying our entry. Green Valley, that's us. And then we have this sign, Presidio of Tubac. I don't know if you can read it, but it says garrisoned by Spanish in 1752. First town established in Arizona by Europeans. Here on March 3rd, 1859, the Weekly Arizonan was published, Arizona's first newspaper, historical marker erected by Arizona Newspapers Association, 1959, just in case you couldn't read that. And then we have, you know, like I said, a desert garden over here, some more cow tongue, prickly pear, some desert spoon, the other regular prickly pear. We've got some metal road runners down here and these big, I think these are grinding wheels or something right here. Tubac Presidio State Park, operated by volunteers. Enter through the building at the left, and we will do that. Again, little garden, barrel cactus, prickly pear. I'm not sure what that is, but some kind of an agave. And then you can see they have a little metal javelina right there, and hiding in the back is a metal roadrunner. And they have a couple of really cool benches over here with some imagery of the Presidio. That's pretty cool. Here's another one. Okay, I'll pause and we'll go inside. Okay, this is where we're gonna enter right here. Beautiful little cactus in the corner. Welcome to the Tubac Presidio, and I'll ask if we can video inside. Hang on. Okay guys, we're in the visitor center, and I've spoken to the ladies at the desk, and I have permission to video. And they're very helpful. They did give us some material that they have up here. And they loaned us a walking guide. My wife is gonna help us go take a tour of what's available out here. So as we walk out this door, I'm gonna put my glasses on. Sorry, folks. Here's where we start the walking tour, Presidio State Park. And then they told us over here in the white building are restrooms, but the tour actually starts to the left. So we're gonna go this way, and we'll be back in a minute. Just real quick, I almost missed this when we walked out the door, but look right here, it's a little cannon. That's pretty cool. And then there's a little cart, and there's a fence over there with a gate, another cart a little bit further out. But stand by, and we're gonna go to the first building. This is right by the sign I just showed you, and this is the overview that talks about Tubac. I'm gonna get up, I can't get any closer than this with it out at not fitting, but I'm gonna come over here and close up on the text. So if you wanna pause and read it, you can do that. But that's a beautiful sign. Okay, we are now gonna go left, stand by. Okay, so we're at the first stop, and this is right here. What they're showing on the sign is a rendering of the captain's house of the Presidio. So basically, this is where they said the rocks kind of outline the original house here and the rooms that were in the house. So just showing you that. And again, there's a sign if you want to pause and try to read it. Right next to two is stop number three. Sorry, my shadow's on there. It's the children's garden. And there's a little wagon here with a little tub on it, and it says to go left here. I'm going to walk through the little path right here and show you these other couple of signs. They have like a hopscotch thing here. Yeah, here we go. Marbles. There we go. Marbles and hopscotch. Hope you can read that. And then we come around here. And they have jump rope and school, lemon lime. And then over here, there are some picnic tables where I guess you could sit down if you wanted to for a few minutes and then hang on. We'll continue around. Okay guys, so this is the schoolhouse right here. I'll back up and show you a bigger shot, but I wanted you to see the sign. It says this is the second oldest standing schoolhouse in Arizona. So if you want to take a look at that, go ahead. And then let me back up and show you the building here. There we go. Okay, hang on. Before we leave the school area and go inside, check out the school bell. There you go. All right, we are heading inside. Okay, as we walk inside, this is the first thing we see, 1885 schoolhouse. And I think we have to go through one of these doors. So, I'm gonna look at that. Okay, we're gonna go try a door, hang on. Okay, it looks like they're setting up for some kind of a concert later, but this is the school building. Some little desks over here that probably got moved to the side for concert seating. Yep. For your reading pleasure. Beautiful wood stove. And then I'll go from left to right on some of these pictures over here. Frederick P. King map collection. Yep. I know we can't show everything here, but I'm just trying to give you a flavor. Okay. I guess these are some of the old items that were used in the school. In these cases. Okay, hang on. So basically at number four here, they're just letting us know that this is where the original Santa Gertrudis Church was. And oh, now there's a new church over there, and I guess that was stood up in 1917. So we're going to proceed. Also at stop four here, they want us to see this iron bender. And this was for making wheels. And as you can see, leaning up against the tree, that's what would come out of the iron bender. Apparently it was sent through this machine when it was red hot, and then you would work it until you got a round shape. So number five right here is just adobe ruins right there. I don't want to walk out in there. From the Spanish colonial period, there's just a little bit of ruins left here. And then we have cow tongue, prickly pear, and Santa Rita prickly pear. Hang on. So number six is Stairway to the Past, as you can see right there. And also here, they have a telescope that looks up to Mount Wrightson and Mount Hopkins, and you can see the observatory up there on the peak on the left. So we're going to go downstairs and then go underground and look at the ruins of the Presidio, the footings and so forth. Stand by. Okay, we're at the bottom of the stairs and we're coming into the underground area. And let me start on the left. There's some things on the wall. And then in here, try to go slow so you can read each thing. Behind glass. Things they found when they excavated. Okay, move on here. There's some more things on the wall. Let me back up and you'll have to come here for yourself. So you can spend a little time seeing all of this. Okay, we're at number 7 at this point, and it's an arastra. And as you can see, this had animals attached to it, and they would walk in a circle and drag these huge rocks, which would crush up ore in that little pit right there. And as we're over here, you know, there's some more things. Silver mines in the Santa Rita Mountains, Tumacacori Mission. Here's number 8, museum. What does it say about number 8? And hang on, I'm gonna push the arastra here and see if I can do it.
It's called Molinos, and they're round grindstones.
Oh my gosh. Oh man. That's hard to do. Okay, what were these grindstones used for?
Molinos, and they were used to grind wheat and corn into flour.
Okay, so these are molinos, and they were used to grind wheat and corn into flour. As you can see, there's some dishes and things back here, and then you've got these other signs up here. Here's the sign in the museum, so we'll go in there. By the way, this is number 10. Come here if you visit. This is definitely worth it. And it's a $5 donation. $5 donation. $5. Okay, I think we're at number 11, which is Rojas' house out of 13 here. I know this video is long, but we're going to wrap it up here pretty soon. So there is Rojas' house. And it just says it was a four-room Mexican adobe row house, and it sits on a small knoll just north of the original town site. So we're going to come back here and check out Ortero Hall. Okay. Number 12. Ortero Hall, which is this big building right here. Let me back up and show it to you. Hang on. Okay, that's Ortero Hall. And what does it say about Ortero Hall?
A particular family got a land grant and gave the funds to build this in 1914.
Some family got a land grant and funds to build this in 1914.
And weddings and other social plus civic events were held here.
And we're going to go to 13. I know this is getting long. I'm so sorry. Hold on. Okay, guys, this is where we're going to wrap it. I know the video is long, but in this Ortero Hall, it's like another museum. You really need to go in there. It is amazing. So that's the last thing on the walking tour. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks.